Okay, so we have a region bounded by y equals to 4x and y equals x cubed, like this. Y equals x cubed and y equals to 4x is like that. Now, this thing actually bounds two regions, but we will only take the first quadrant and call it R. So we're only thinking about this one as R. We should also figure out when they meet each other, and the place they meet is, well, if I set them equal to each other, x cubed equal to 4x, x cubed minus 4x equal to 0, factoring the x out, I get x squared minus 4 equals to 0, so either x is 0 or x squared minus 4 is 0, in which case x squared is 4, that gives you x equals to plus minus 2. So we know that they meet at negative 2, 0, and 2, but since we're only interested in the first quadrant, we just need these two coordinates. This one's 0 comma 0. What is this one? This is what comma what? 2 comma. What's the y coordinate?
8.
How do you get 8?
You plug it in.
You plug in 2 into either one of them. They both give you 8. So that's 2 comma 8. Okay. Knowing this, now let's try to figure out how to solve the first one. We want to rotate around x equals to 2, x equals to 2. If you rotate around this, I guess the picture would be something like this, where in the interior, it's hollowed in this form. Let's use washer method, meaning horizontal cross sections. We need to take cross sections. So that when you take the cross section, you end up with something like a washer. Now, in order to recover the entire volume, we have to thicken these washers and add them up, right? So we have to thicken it. In which direction are we thickening it?
Y.
In the y direction. So we should be putting, what should I write this as?
dy,
because it's increasing in the y direction. It's dy. And then we also need the small r and the big r for the washer method to work. So let's go back to this picture and think about what the small r and the big r is. So if we took a cross section here, then the small r would be the distance between these two graphs, whereas the big R would be this one, from here to there. And these are horizontal distances, which means we need the distance between the x coordinates. If you want the horizontal distance, you need the distance between the x coordinates. If you need the vertical distance, you need the distance between the y coordinates. That's how it works. Okay? So let's try that first. We want to find distance between this curve and this straight line. Let's write down horizontal distance from y equals to x cubed to x equals to 2. Is, well, since you need the x coordinates, you have to solve both of them for x. This is already solved for x, so we first have to solve this for x, which gives you x equal to cube root of y, just by taking the cube root both sides. And you're basically taking the difference between the two. just like if you want to know the distance between 2 to 5, what's the distance? 3, how do you get 3? You do 5 minus 2, right? You have to be always careful that you're subtracting big minus the small. If you do the opposite way, then your distance comes out negative. That's not what it is. So since 2 is on the right side, that's probably bigger than this one, right? So we will do 2 minus this as the distance. So you take the difference, and therefore, from here to there is 2 minus cube root of y. And what do you call this? Small r or big R? It's the small r. We agreed on that, right? Horizontal distance from y equals to 4x to x equals to 2 is, once again you solve for x, so x is y over 4. And now you do big minus small, 2 minus y over 4. And that is equal to big R. Then you're ready to write down the integral. Volume is sum of small volumes, which are made up of these very thin cross sections, very thin washers. Those washers are made up of pi times big R squared. Big R squared minus the small r squared. D1. Pi, big R squared is the area of the big circle. Pi small r squared is the area of the small circle. So if you subtract them, you get the area of the washer. And you're multiplied by dy to thicken it. And then now y goes from where to where? What's the least value of y?
0.
Maximum value of y?
8.
That's why we had to figure out this coordinate, because this is 2, 8. We know that y goes up to 8. So if you compute this, you get the answer, which I don't want to do. Because it's straightforward, so let's leave it there. Sometimes even in the exam, I might say, write down the integral that expresses the volume of this, but you don't have to compute it. Okay. Let's now do part B. Part B does the following. This time, instead of x equals to 2, you have y equals to negative 1. And you're trying to rotate that way, so you're going to get this thing, when it's rotated, you're going to get something like this on the other side. And on this side, it'll be completely empty, so there's a hole in the middle. We're trying to find volume of this object. Again, we work with the cross sections. Whose cross sections look like washers? And we have to thicken it, right? Which direction do we thicken it? X. So we write down dx. Oh, there's one thing I forgot to say. When you write down these integrals, make sure that if you're integrating by dy, your functions are in y. If I have dx, that means all my functions that I'm integrating should be in x. If they don't mesh, suppose I was trying to write down the answer to the first one, I chose dy and this is in terms of x, then something's wrong. You have to figure out what your mistake is. That's why I'm always asking you whether it's dx or dy. If you get this one wrong, then you might not be able to calculate anything. This seemingly very benign small thing does actually have a big impact in your answer. Okay? Now we're going to work with vertical distances. vertical distance from, well, since we're dividing, like taking the cross section this way, if I have this distance, I would need the distance from y equals to 4x to y equals to negative 1. In which case, what do you get? How do you get the distance? Should I do 4x minus negative 1 or negative 1 minus 4x?
4x minus negative
1. 4x minus negative 1 because, as you can see, 4x is above negative 1. You should absolutely use the graph to determine which should be subtracted from which, okay? So you know that you need to do 4x minus negative 1, which gives you 4x plus 1, and that's equal to?
Little r.
No.
Big R.
Why?
Because it's the straight line.
It's this straight line, and we were talking about this distance. That's bigger than this one. If you rotate this around, this is going to be the small r, and this is going to be the big R. Okay? So that's your big R. From y equals x cubed to y equals to negative 1, that's going to be x cubed minus negative 1, which is x cubed plus 1. That's your small r. Then your volume is sum of bits of volume. If you add all small bits of volume, then you end up with the entire volume. And the bits of volumes are these very, very thin slices that look like washers. And you get that by multiplying the cross-section area, which is r squared minus the small r squared. And then you multiply this by dx to thicken it. And what's the least value and the maximum value of x?
0, 2.
And once again, I'll just stop here. You can calculate.